Hello, my name is Andreas Hauser from TÜV SÜD Digital Service. I would like to give you an overview about the gateway to Industry 4.0. The idea is that delegates who may visit this big fair, this Industry Transformation Asia Pacific Fair, may be overwhelmed by the many different technologies and solutions. So we thought we would like to introduce the delegates to this very complex topic, Industry 4.0, by setting up this gateway to Industry 4.0. It consists of 5 zones. And please allow me to guide you through these 5 zones now. Thank you. So we are here in zone 1. This is the introductory to Industry 4.0. It gives you an overview about the different industrial revolutions. You can see here in the background from the first to the fourth industrial revolution, some key inventions and also the global impact, but also the impact particularly on Asia Pacific. Important maybe to mention is that the fourth industrial revolution, although it's just about to happening, is already anticipated, which is a novelty in this regard, because normally you talk about a revolution after it happened actually. So we're still in zone 1. In the back you see the global map of the key initiatives regarding Industry 4.0. There is worthwhile mentioning, of course, Germany as being a pioneer of Industry 4.0, coined the term Industry 4.0, but there are also other global initiatives, particularly in the US with a more IT-focused approach, China as well, developing many Industry 4.0 solutions and also adopting those solutions. We see Japan with its Society 5.0 approach, with a focus on the impact of society. And last but not least, actually, we have Singapore with its broad smart nation initiative. We see with this concerted effort with the government, with academia, but also with the industry, that we will create a strong momentum with Industry 4.0 transformations. And with this, I would like to proceed to the second zone, which is about the vision. So this is zone 2, about the vision of Industry 4.0. You see here in the background the global trends and facts and figures of Industry 4.0. For instance, a massive increase of productivity is just one aspect of it. You see also many features actually, like hyperconnectivity or robotics as one of the features of Industry 4.0, but it's not only about the technology itself, it's really about integrating this into a holistic concept. You also see on the right-hand side some key facts regarding Asia-Pacific. Given that Asia-Pacific is the manufacturing powerhouse worldwide, we see, of course, huge opportunities in this region. Now we move on to our augmented reality wall, where you can see and get a glimpse of the future of Industry 4.0. Here you see the different functions of a classical manufacturer, starting from management, research, development, production, to finally delivery and after-sales market. We see that this is currently very sequential, so there's a clear defined process from the beginning to the end, from R&D to production to delivery. We see that Industry 4.0 means a more flexible connection of the different functions, actually. The key here is really that you can share, exchange data, information from different functions as fast as possible. And Industry 4.0 ultimately is the integration of the different functions. So with this, let me please proceed to the next zone about the impact. So we're here in zone 3, the impact of Industry 4.0 on the different stakeholders, namely the manufacturer, workforce, the government, and also the environment. The consumer is really in the heart of this development, is a key driver. He wants to have products very individualized, they want to have it promptly delivered, and they want a very convenient way of purchasing it. We have shown here the top 5 consumer trends: hyper-personalization, sustainability, just to name 2 of them. And with this, I would like to show you now the impact on the environment, government, and also workforce. Here we see the impact on environment, government and the workforce. On the environment side, we see that Industry 4.0 solutions can increase the resources efficiency, so you use less material, you reduce your waste, and this can be converted into tangible business benefits. On the government side, which plays a key role in forming that ecosystem, we also see the need for more forward-looking standards, for more flexible regulatory frameworks, and also for being more supportive in terms of funding, for instance. Third, but definitely not least stakeholder, is workforce. Repetitive tasks will be replaced by machines more and more, and workforce can refocus more on strategic topics, on improvement topics, so that they are more released from the operations. A key governing theme in the workforce is definitely upskilling, to make people really capable of dealing with the new challenges and with the new tasks. So let me now show you a simple example, actually, where we see the difference between the classical way of ordering, for instance, a pair of glasses, right? In the classical way, you go to an optometrist, you let measure your eyes, and then it takes maybe 1 to 2 weeks to get your glasses fabricated. The new world looks different, actually. You will be, your face will be scanned with your mobile phone, the iris will be scanned, so the eye test will be done online. This is e-commerce in a sense, but important now to see really on the manufacturing side. We see that on that back end, there we see a big change regarding that from the purchase order of the consumer, it must go directly to the manufacturer with cutting out the middleman. And that means basically individualized production facilities delivered in time. And here on the left side, we then show the impact on the manufacturing. Assume now the consumer has purchased the order. It goes directly to the manufacturer. You see on the design phase that maybe there are a few adjustments pretty much done automatically, and then it will go seamlessly in the production and from the production then into the delivery. Again, the concept is mainly to integrate all these different functions that you can share and exchange data in a very seamless way, so that you basically can then deliver this product promptly to the consumer. Thank you. So we're here now in zone 4, the transformation zone, and it's about how to start basically this Industry 4.0 transformation journey. We have heard many concepts, many solutions, many ideas, many visions, but how really to start your journey, your transformation journey. And we see here on this wall that it starts always with the initiation, with the proper baseline of your current situation. And the gap analysis, and the next step is then to find the right solution to solve your specific problems, and then up to the operations. One key tool in the initiation phase is actually the Smart Industry Readiness Index, which has been developed by Economic Development Board from Singapore and TÜV SÜD together, which is shown on the right side here. We have assessed already 200 companies with this assessment tool, and it really helps companies to initiate, to scale and sustain their transformation journey. There are other showcases here displayed where companies are shown who already embarked on this transformation journey. And I would like to show you some quotes from companies who have already started this. This is zone 5. It's about the embarking on the Industry 4.0 journey. Probably one of the most exciting zones here, because we see many quotes from different companies, from big MNC companies, but also smaller and medium-sized enterprises in Singapore, TÜV SÜD clients who have successfully applied the Smart Industry Readiness Index. It's really impressive how to see the positive feedback, how it really helped translating this Industry 4.0 concept into their specific situations. So with this, I hope that this gateway to Industry 4.0 also helps you to start and transform successfully. Thank you.